In the small town of Ashwood, there was a vendor, James, who used to sell hot dogs. James and his wife Stacy used to sell hot dogs in the town, but they didn't have many customers. The customers usually didn't return for more. James always wondered why his customers don't come back.
"I don't understand what is wrong with these people, why they are not eating as they used to do. Sale has been down nowadays."
"I don't know, but the sales have fallen very low."
"I don't like the hot dogs that you make. Then why will customers like it?"
"If it is so, then why don't you prepare the hot dogs? Only then you will understand how difficult it is."
Okay, I get it.
There is a woman in our village. The food she prepares is very tasty. If she will make hot dogs for us, then I'm sure we'll get more customers. Tomorrow, I will go to my village and ask her to come with me. Our business will improve and we will earn more."
James went to his village where Sarah lived. He went to her house.
"Oh, Mr. James, please come. How come you're here?"
"Yes, there is. That's why I have come here."
"What is it? Please tell me."
"Sarah, I know that you make delicious hot dogs and I have a small business of hot dog. I need someone who make hot dogs. Will you work for me? I will pay you a good amount of money."
"That is a wonderful idea. I will work for you. It will help my family financially."
"Great, then we will leave for the town in the evening."
Sarah came to town with James. James told her to prepare 100 hot dogs every morning. The next morning, Sarah prepared hot dogs as James has ordered. Like every other day, James and Stacy started selling the hot dogs. That day, they sold all of the hot dogs. They earned a good profit. James gave half of the profit to Sarah.
"Sarah, we earned a lot of money today. Please take half of the profit. It's yours."
"Thank you, brother."
"Tomorrow, I'll need 200 hot dogs because now we have more customers."
"I will keep 200 hot dogs ready in the morning. You just buy me all the necessary ingredients."
The next morning, Sarah made 200 hot dogs. That day, James sold all the 200 hot dogs. James ordered Sarah to prepare 300 hot dogs. Now it's a daily routine. Sarah would make lots of hot dogs and give it to James. And James earned a lot of money by selling tasty hot dogs to his customers. But Stacy becomes jealous after seeing this. One day she told James,
"Dear, why do you give half of the profit to Sarah? We buy all the ingredients, we stand in the shop all day to sell hot dogs, and she gets half of the profit for making hot dogs in the comfort of her house. This is not right."
"Yes, my dear, but I don't have any other option. I'm earning a lot of profit from the hot dogs Sarah made."
"And you share the profit in half. Think carefully."
"You are right, but I cannot fire her from this job. We will lose the business."
"Don't give her a profit or salary. Pay her on daily basis. Understand?"
"Okay, this is a better option. We will pay her daily."
The next morning, James ordered Sarah to make 300 hot dogs and told her,
"Sarah, the price of all the things has gone up and I'm facing loss in the business. Now I can give you only 100 rupees per day."
"But brother, you promised that you will give me half of the profit. Did you forget? I anyhow earned 100 rupees in the village. I came here to earn more. And don't forget, your customers are buying hot dogs because they are tasty."
"Sarah, you are being greedy. It is not a good thing."
"I am greedy? Or is it you are greedy? I have never compromised with my work. So I will take full payment as decided."
"Get out of my house. I don't agree. You deserve to live in a small village. You can never do better than this."
Poor Sarah and her children left his house. After walking for a few hours, they took a break. Her elder son, Matt, said,
"Mom, please don't worry. We'll find a solution to this problem. Why don't we start our own business? We have saved some money. We can use it to start our own business."
"I think you're right. We will start our own business."
The next day, Sarah and her son started their hot dog business and they started in the heart of the town next to the James business. That day, Sarah made just 50 hot dogs, but her business was new and hence she didn't have many customers on the first day. She became very sad.
"Son, do you think we made a mistake by starting the business?"
"Mom, today was the first day of this business. How we will know if people liked our hot dogs or not? We will try it again tomorrow."
The next day, Sarah and Matt made 50 hot dogs again and started selling them. After some time, a man comes to buy a hot dog.
"How much for a hot dog?"
only 10 rupees.
The man liked the taste of the hot dog that he ate. He ordered to pack 10 more hot dogs for his family. As time passed, Sara now had more customers. People loved her hot dogs, and James started losing his customers one by one. Even everyone was talking about Sara's delicious hot dog. One day, a very wealthy businessman in the town came to her shop.
"Please give me a hot dog."
Sara gave him a hot dog and got back to her work. The businessman liked her hot dog very much.
"Sister, my son is getting married the day after tomorrow. Will you make tasty hot dogs for all guests? I'll pay you for all of the hot dogs."
"I will make it, and I will try to give them the best hot dog they have ever eaten."
"Please take this as an advance."
Businessman left after giving Sara some money in advance. When James saw this, he became very jealous, but he knew that he cannot say a word to her.
"I think we should start some other business. We are not earning much profit from this hot dogs business."
"You are right. Let's start some other business."
In this way, James and Stacy had to stop their business. Their greed and lies become the reason that they had suffered a loss. But Sara's hot dog business was doing great. The moral of the story is that we should always fulfill our promises and never betray anyone's trust.
Mary the maid had started working as a cook in Harold's home few days ago. Harold's pregnant wife Rachel used to treat her very nicely. She used to give tea and breakfast to her, and sometimes even lunch.
"Mary, first drink your tea. It's a cold weather."
Sure, madam, I will drink it.
"And this is my old sweater. I have only worn it twice. If you want, you can take it."
Harold used to go to his office very early in the morning. After that, Mary used to come to their home to cook food. Mary made delicious food. Rachel was also happy with her work. Slowly, Mary won Rachel's trust completely.
"Mary, I'm going to the temple. Take care of the house."
"Yes, madam. You don't worry."
Rachel started going to the temple every day for 1 hour, and Mary used to be alone in the home. Harold had received 4 bags of basmati rice from the village. Mary got greedy.
"There are just 2 people in this home, and so much rice. If I take 2 bowls of rice from this bag, no one will even notice."
Mary took 2 bowls of rice from the bag and kept it in her purse. She closed the rice bag as before.
"Amazing! Today I will make fried rice at home."
Mary's greed and daring was increasing day by day. She would take rice, sugar, and sometimes tea leaves and vegetables. Every day, something or the other from Harold's home used to reach Mary's home. Mary had stuck gold.
"Oh wow! You have found a golden goose. But take care, or else you will be caught."
"Yes, don't worry. Madam trusts me completely."
"That's good. I don't need to work anymore."
Things from the home were slowly disappearing, but Rachel didn't notice. She still trusted Mary. Then one day, Rachel's mother-in-law comes to visit.
"Greetings, mother." "Oh, don't bother, daughter-in-law. How are you feeling now?" "It's fine. I just feel tired sometimes. Don't worry. It's normal in pregnancy. Now I'm here to take care of you. Let's click a selfie first."
Rachel introduces mother-in-law to Mary.
"Mother, she's Mary. She cooks for us and takes care of other small things in our home. She supports me a lot." Okay. That's fine."
Rachel's mother-in-law was very smart and tech-savvy. She could easily get a hang of a person just by observing them. When Rachel used to go to the temple, she used to sit on the swing to pray. And in every 15 minutes, she used to walk into the kitchen. Because of her presence in the house, Mary was not able to steal things.
When will this old lady go back? I'm afraid to steal anything now."
Mary's clever mind notices something. When mother-in-law sits on the swing, it creaks, and it takes 10 minutes for her to complete a round of praying on the beads.
"Okay, so this means that this old lady will not get up from there for 10 minutes, huh? This time is enough for me."
For the next 2-3 days, Mary is successful in stealing a few things. She feels happy.
"I'm going home. I've kept the food in the fridge."
"Okay."
As Mary is leaving the house, mother-in-law notices a suspicious bulge in Mary's bag.
Huh? When she came in the morning, her bag was folded. How come it's full now?
Next day, Mary comes to work.
Mary, Rachel has left for the temple and I'm sitting for my prayers. Later, I will come to the kitchen to make some sweets. Okay.
Mary comes to the kitchen. She can hear the creak of the swing. She assumes that now mother-in-law will not get up for 10 minutes.
This lady will not come here for 10 minutes now. I should put some vegetables in my bag.
Mary finishes her work and starts to leave for her home.
I'm leaving for home.
Okay, what are you going to cook at home today?
Thought of making mixed vegetables today.
Okay, that's good. So how many vegetables did you take?
Huh?
She is surprised to hear this question from the mother-in-law, but manages to answer.
I haven't bought it yet. I will buy them on my way home.
During this, Rachel also comes back.
But you already have the vegetables in your bag. Let me see.
Mary realizes that she has been caught and she feels guilty.
Mother, how did you know?
Mother-in-law starts laughing and shows Rachel the video she recorded in her mobile. Rachel is surprised to see Mary put vegetables in her bag in the video.
Please forgive me. I did a mistake. But weren't you praying at that time? I could hear the sound of the swing. That's why I could gather the courage to steal.
Maybe you didn't notice me holding Rachel's beads, not mine. And if you push the swing once, it will keep swinging for at least 5 minutes. It gave me enough time to record.
So that's how the mother-in-law taught Mary a lesson, who was a greedy maid. Now Mary couldn't work in that area anymore.
Oh God, what have I done? I dug my own grave. Mother, today we have been saved from loss because of you.
But daughter-in-law, remember, you should also not trust anyone blindly from now. Not everyone is good in this world.
A man named Michael lived in a village. He had a big dairy shop. He used to provide milk, curd, and other dairy products in his shop.
Hey, what is this? Where did so many flies come today? Oh shit, let me throw this before anyone sees.
Michael was a miser. Uncle Michael, please give me 2 kg butter.
Sure son, I will give you right away.
Hey, what is this? Uncle Michael, there is a fly in it.
What? A fly? Show me.
The boy shows Michael the box of butter.
Wait, son. I will give you another box of butter.
Michael takes out the fly from the box and hands over the same box to the boy.
Take this, son. Is it okay now?
Yes, Uncle Michael. Thank you. I will leave now. At that time, there arrived 2 sepoys from the palace.
Listen, Michael. 40 kg butter should be delivered by noon in the palace.
Yeah, sure. But such a high quantity of butter, is there a party in palace today?
Yes. Today the king has thrown a party for the ministers.
Okay. Don't worry. You will get the butter on time.
Sepoys leave. And Michael starts preparing butter.
Listen, Simon. We have to deliver 40 kg of butter to the palace by afternoon. Let's start working quickly. But master, we don't have enough milk to prepare 40 kg of butter. Do one thing, add half quantity water to the milk we have. That will do the work. But master, that will not be right. If the king finds this out, then he will punish us. You do your work quietly or get lost. Oh, okay, master.
Simon adds water to the milk, but even then, the quantity is not enough. Simon goes to his master to inform him.
Master, I added water to the milk, but even then, preparing 40 kg of butter is not possible. What shall we do now? Okay. You go out there and look after the shop. I will take care of this. Okay, master. I should add vegetable oil to this.
Michael takes the case of vegetable oil and adds the butter, and that fills the case of butter fully.
Wow, my work is done. Now I have to deliver this to the palace quickly.
Michael takes the case of butter to the palace and returns home after delivering that. All the ministers arrive at the party.
The party was wonderful.
The king welcomes the ministers wholeheartedly. All the ministers eat a lot of food. After the dinner, ministers meet the king and go back to their homes. The king offers each minister a box of sweet as return gift.
Wow, the aroma of the sweets is so good. I will also taste the sweets.
The king tasted the sweet happily. The ministers also enjoyed the sweets just like the king.
After eating the sweets, the king falls sick.
Your Highness, the ministers have also fallen sick like you. What? How's this possible? Seems like something was wrong with the sweets. Go and call the chef.
Yes, Your Highness.
You fool! What kind of sweet did you make? Everyone has fallen sick after eating your sweets.
Your Highness, I prepared it very carefully. I have no idea what happened. Your Highness, I think all this happened because of Michael's butter.
Are you sure that all have fallen sick because of that butter?
Yes, Your Highness, because I could smell vegetable oil in that butter.
This means Michael cheats everyone with adulteration. General, send 2 sepoys to Michael's house to keep an eye on him. Yes, Your Highness.
Sepoys, I arrive at Michael's house and sneak up.
The Michael was adding vegetable oil to the butter.
Oh, what's this? Michael is putting everyone in trouble by adulteration. Yes, we should catch him red-handed and take him to the king.
Yes, come quickly.
Sepoys enter Michael's house and catch him red-handed.
You adulterate butter? Now you will have to answer the king. No, please forgive me.
Come. Now you will explain things to the king.
Sepoys bring Michael to the palace.
Your Highness, we caught Michael red-handed, adulterating butter.
Does this mean that you fool everyone? Please forgive me, Your Highness. I made a mistake. I will never do this. General, take him and throw in jail.
No, Your Highness, please forgive me. I will never do this.
The king does not listen to Michael, and the general throws him in jail.